where Third Street was the railroad tracks, and First Street was basically the bay. Anyways, we lived in this manky warehouse across from an ink factory where toxic fumes just rose up every day. I was sure we were gonna get poisoned. The only thing between us and the railroad tracks was this empty parking lot. So when the train went by, and this was the big California Metro liner that runs all the way up and down the coast, and it would go by 4, 5, 6 times a day and all through the night. When the train would go by, the whole building would shake. And the whistle would just blow so loud and then fade away. Daytime, nighttime. It was the coolest sound I ever heard. It was a weird warehouse. There was this big grating on the wall, about 6 feet by 6 feet. It hung about 10 feet in the air. It had little holes along it. And when you turn the switch on the wall, it would go click, 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 and the whole fucking thing would burst into flame. It was the singularly most unsafe heating system I have ever seen. Just this wall, this 6 foot by 6 foot wall of fire that hung 10 feet above us in the air. It looked so cool. I might have been drunk a lot back then, but having a fireplace that hangs off your wall 10 feet in the air just seemed so fucking cool in the state I was in. And during our days, we would rummage through every used record bin in the Bay Area, trying to find whatever we didn't have yet. We would go to the 99 cent store up on San Pablo. We would buy bashed in boxes of macaroni and cheese and dented cans of Progresso soup because we didn't have a lot of money. We spent our days trying to figure out how to get from being kids to being adults, because starting out as a musician does not pay very well. But that was just our days. At night, I mean every night, every single fucking night, we went out to the clubs to play music, or we went to our rehearsal spaces to rehearse to play music, or we went to the clubs to watch our friends play music, but every night was music, and that was the sound of loud guitars and the crash of cymbals was the sound that carried us from childhood to adulthood. That was the thing that was gonna make us, so every night we went out and we made it right back. We made the loudest sounds we could, night after night. Just trying to get someone, anyone, to notice us. And you did. Gets you through. Got us. There's a girl out on a car over in the parking lot. She says, "Hey, man, come on, come on, come on, come on, just take a shot."
Around, I watch the sky go blue, black, green.
awful fate. There was some blood.